What's up, guys, and welcome to another episode here on NRV Outdoors. Today we're here on one of our favorite little creeks to do some trout fishing. Now, as a lot of you guys know, I love to fish the Trout Magnet, but we've got a lot of you new viewers that have been following the channel, and you guys have been sending me a lot of questions about how to fish the Trout Magnet. And in today's video, guys, we're going to do a big throwback video on the basics of Trout Magnet fishing and everything you need to know to be successful while out using the float rig and the jig. So guys, all we've got here is our very simple little 1/64th ounce Trout Magnet hook. It's in a black color, and we've got a little bubblegum pink grub on here, guys. This is a split tail. The Trout Magnets are split tailed. They've got a fantastic little look under the water. Now, when it comes to the knot, a lot of people will tell you to use a loop knot, and the loop knot will work well, but what I have found over time, guys, is in the very bend of that little eye there, there's this gap, just a very small separation, and that loop will often get stuck underneath that gap, creating for a fouled up bait. So what I like to do is tie a very simple fisherman's knot or a polymer knot, and I'll clench it very tight to the eye there, and I'll pull it down to create that nice 90 degree angle you're looking for. Now, when it comes to line, guys, I like to use 8 pound line. The weight of your line really is determined on how big a fish you think you could catch. If there's 10 pounders in your waterway or 10 pounds plus, you might want to consider that 8 pound. But if your biggest fish in the whole creek is 2 pound, then you can probably get away with that 2 pound line. The line is completely up to you guys. And we've got our little indicator up here, guys. Trout Magnet has got one of the most innovative little floats on the market. It's got a small slit, as you can see right there. You just pop your line into that slit there and you can peg it down with that peg. And you can adjust it by sliding it back and forth to make the depth of your overall presentation higher or lower. So let's not waste any time, guys. Let's go ahead and get in here and do some fishing. We'll talk about how we separate our float, what we're looking for, and we'll catch some fish, guys. So go ahead and stick around and let's have some fun. All right, guys. So if you look across this little stretch of water that we have here, you'll notice that it's quite shallow. And the separation we have here would probably be too much. So that would make our little Trout Magnet rig here drag the bottom and get hung up a lot. So all we do, guys, is we just simply pinch that float, pull it closer to the Trout Magnet, just like that there, making a smaller separation. And then we'll cast it in here, guys. Now, if you notice that your bobber's going down a lot, that most likely would indicate that you're hitting the bottom, especially if you're setting the hook and not catching any fish. And all you need to do to fix that problem there, guys, just like that right there, if you notice, we hit the bottom, and I set the hook thinking it could be a fish. It was just the bottom. So we bring that separation even closer to our jig, and we cast it out there. Now, vice versa works as well, guys. If you make a ton of casts to a location and you never see your bobber twitch and you're not getting any bites, then it's probably a good time to open up your separation even more, allowing that jig to get down there closer to the fish, closer to the bottom, and hopefully catch you a fish. But the separation is really the key to catching fish on the Trout Magnet. The line, the knot, the way you cast it isn't nearly as important, or the way you jig it, as the separation from your float to the jig, guys. It's so very important, because if the lure is not in the strike zone, the fish simply can't strike it. He crushed it over there, spit it out immediately. Let's try that same cast again. That fish absolutely crushed it. Go ahead and open up that separation some more. Right until we're starting to notice that bobber twitching a little bit. We want to get on down there on this cast. Got him on. Beautiful little rainbow trout. On the old pink Trout Magnet. She absolutely smoked it. Heck yeah. Heck yeah. Absolutely smoked it. Oh, calm down, calm down. Get back in the net. We're going to set you free. Angry fish. She still thinks she's swimming in the creek there. There we go. Popped herself off. We'll just let her go. Well, I'm thinking to make this video a little more interesting, let's go on ahead and make this a bit of a challenge. Let's let's go ahead and switch up colors and just try to see how many colors we can work our way through today, guys. That one came on the pink color, a fantastic color, one of the top picks. But my favorite color is that black and green. So let's go on ahead and throw it in here, guys. Let's see what they think of it. Seeing some brown trout swimming around. So I feel pretty confident we can get ourselves one. Just rig that little magnet right on up like that. Bring that hook right out of the split tails. Just like that right there, guys. And that's all there is to it. Oh, he was on it immediately. Bit it on the fall. He's got it again. We got him. Black and green, one of my favorites. The fish just cannot help it. He's used a jumper too. Heck yeah, guys. Heck yeah. Did not take long to get one on the black and green. Less than a half dozen casts. There we go, guys. There we go. Grab our old jig right there. Oh, angry little girl, angry. Might have to use her fingers for this one. Oh, she popped the line. That's never a good sign. There we go, popped her off. Let that little beauty just swim right on back into the creek. Heck yeah, guys. Alrighty, boys and girls. I'm thinking up next, let's go with that straight pearl white color there. It works really good on a black jig head, as it looks very much like a small minnow. Let's just rig him right on up on here, guys. Down the body, out through the split tails. Let's bomb out our very first cast with it. Got him. Ooh, nice one. On that white color. Little rainbow. Oh, he's so angry too. My gosh, is he ever. That old white color got that one right there. Heck yeah, guys. Reach on in here, try to pop her loose here. Fight a little bit in the net there. Angry fish today. There we go. Beautiful fish on that white color. Let's just let her go. Let's see here. So we've done the pink and the black and green, and we've done the white. So let's go with that awesome neon yellow color right there. Brown trout really like the color yellow. And I've seen a few nice brownies in here, so pretty good chance we can get ourselves one hooked up on this little yellow magnet here. Same rig, guys, right down the middle, out through the tails. Let's see what happens. Oh, I see how you are. Oh, I see how you are. You took that old yellow magnet. One jump to our left, got my attention, and the bobber went down. Another pretty little rainbow on that chartreuse yellow. Heck yeah, guys. Careful. Oh, managed to hook me a little bit. Gorgeous little fish right there. Let's just let that one go. All right, guys, I'm thinking one more color trout magnet, and then we're going to talk about the true magic of this little jig head here and why it is I'm always using it. So let's put this little puppy up right here. I'm thinking, to make it somewhat difficult, we'll go with that gold color there. We've got those cheese and we've got these two spliced ones, but I'm thinking we'll go with the old gold here. Drop that old gold magnet down there. Now, I mentioned it before, guys, but I'll mention again in this video for those of you that are new. Every time you change your trout magnet body, the trout really do get confused. They assume it's a completely different organism, and you can literally go from catching no fish to changing your color after every bite and catch every fish in the area, just because it messes with them so much passing a bait of one color and then seeing another one come by of a different color, they just assume that it's something different and they'll feed on it. It's just a fantastic way to use your trout magnets to your advantage. Got him. Nice one too, by golly. Nice fish. Angry one. Shoo-wee, is that fish angry? Fighting so hard down there. Big old brown trout on that gold color. Fantastic, guys. Biggest fish of the day so far. Heck yeah. Light colored brown trout here. Fighting super hard. There we go. Is it a big one right there? Catch him.
I mean, 8 or 9 pounds.
Really? I'm going to come look. I'm going to release this little male right here. Gentleman to our left says he found a big one. So let's let that little whippersnapper go right there. Better put our old net up. Can't catch fish unless the net is in its designated clip there. Why that is, I'm just not sure. Oh, accidentally slapped a butterfly with the tip of the rod there. Don't know if that's good luck or not. He certainly didn't land on it. We gave him a bit of a slap with it. Got him. We got him. Big old brownie right here, guys. Yep, big old brownie. Dark colors. Oh, yeah. Best fish so far today. And he's just nose down digging, guys. Big old angry male brown trout here. Big old angry guy. Wow. Heck yeah, guys. Fish the old trout magnet around. Switched up to that pinch crawler, and these fish are just all over it. Big old hook jaw male right here, guys. Dark colored brown trout, fantastic. Mouth full of sharp teeth, don't want to get our hands in there. A beautiful kipe on this big male right here, guys. He's just a marvelous looking fish. Oh, broke our pinch crawler. See if we can't get our jig head here, guys. Old brown's got a mouth just full of teeth. There we go. Popped him off, no problem. Wow, guys. Best fish of the day so far right there. Just a stud of a brown trout right there. Heck yeah, guys. And he came on that natural pinch crawler. Really no big surprise. The pinch crawler is just a fish catching machine. But I'm thinking we'll switch up and we'll put us on a little trout worm. And I'll show you guys how to rig that and we'll see what we can't do. Alrighty, guys. Another bait that just fishes beautifully on your trout magnet rig is a trout worm. Right here we've got the Berkley power worm, and as you can see, you can just rig it up on there straight, and that jig head will help get that floating worm down there, guys, and it really catch you a couple nice fish. You don't have to add all those split shots on there. You can just simply pop it right onto your trout magnet hook, bomb him out there, and the fish just cannot resist it, guys. They'll come over to get it. Oop, bite on the first cast. We'll just let it fall right there and give these fish a second chance at it here. Missed our very first bite. Got him on the old power worm. Heck yeah, guys. This little fish right here is going to wrap up today's video. Just a quick recap. Fluorocarbon line is probably the most important factor while fishing the trout magnet rig. And changing your separation from your float to your lure is by far the second most important. Once you figure out what the depth of the fish are, guys, it really becomes easy to catch them. And once again, when you're changing up your lures, be sure to switch colors as often as you can. And you'll find that by changing colors, you can catch fish that were letting other colors drift by. And you'll have a lot more success, guys. Let's get this little beauty right here off. There she goes. There we go. Alrighty, guys. That's pretty much going to do it. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you smash that like button. And leave me a comment down below and let me know what your favorite lure or product is to add to your trout magnet. And if it's the trout magnet, be sure to add what's your favorite color. But get out if you can, guys. Do yourself some fishing and have some fun. But most importantly, be safe and tight lines. Wading our way on back across the creek, guys. I almost forgot to mention these gloves I was wearing today. I'm sure you guys noticed. These are some Bass Dash UV protecting gloves, fishing gloves, fingerless. And I was trying them out today. And I'm a big fan, guys. Had no problems with the fish today. And all in all, not too bad. Pretty happy. If you guys would like to check them out, I'll leave a link down below in the description for you. You guys can hit them up. They're pretty inexpensive. They wear really nicely, very flexible, and I think you guys will like them.